If you want to do that, please contact me at Huston University.
A lot of guys you've been covering for years, their expectations, were they all met?
Well, you know, that's why we have an event like this. You know, I mean, sometimes, to be honest with you, they're not always met until, you know, even now. I mean, these kids who thought they played Division One, they had all, last year at this time, the class of 2013 was going through that, you know, we're going to play Division One, and then your expectations lower and lower. So to answer your question, probably in a direct way, until they get that scholarship, it's not really met.
Signing day is the beginning of the process. It's not the end of the process.
Well, that's a good point. That's a good point you make. And well, the whole thing is so much has been made. Everybody wants to sign on National Signing Day. It puts a pressure on the kids. And those kids who are really, like, maybe have grade issues or other issues that they have, they feel left out. And that shouldn't be. I mean, it really shouldn't be like that. But I think as a society, we made that way. The whole recruiting process, when I first started, it was never even close to what it was now. I mean, there was no computers, there was no cell phones, so you do your own math. I mean, I drove up to Gainesville one time just to see if a recruit was going to sign. But back then, you used to have these letter of intent days where you'd sign a letter of intent with the university, like a state school. So if you would sign that would forbid you to play anywhere in the state, but you could play outside the state. So they changed that. But I mean, like, if you committed to Miami or signed with Miami, couldn't play at Florida or Florida State. But I think there's so much pressure on the kids, you know, right now. I mean, because they get to the point where they want to be in the spotlight, but I don't think they're ready for it sometimes.
How many years?
42 years.
42
my
42 years. He may have covered me. You know, I don't know. I know he
covered a lot of people. Yeah.
Guys, and I come from that era. How in the world do you have the time in the day to get as many kids? Because you blow me away.
Yeah.
I mean, you talk about kids that Larry. Like I said, Larry Bluestein recruiting, all the blocks he runs. You talk about the kids. How do you find the time and the day to do this, Larry?
Well, you know, it's funny. It's basically my side job. I operate a regular newspaper, and I've done that for 36 years. I'm the editor, and it has nothing to do with sports. And
okay.
And that's where, you know, I spend most of my time. So just, I mean, but I go statewide. The last 2 years I've flown to Mobile, Alabama, rented a car, and come back through the Panhandle. Got a chance to stop this last year at right over the border in a place called Northview, and the offensive line coach at Northview used to play at University of Miami, Ty Wise, who was a center. His team later went to the state this year and they won. And it's just, yeah, and I do that, and I promote kids, and it's all about the kids to me. I mean, the more and more people who do things like yourself and like everybody else, it's just like more of a relief for me, because we're all doing this for one thing. We're doing this to promote the kids, and that's what you guys are about. That's what events like this are about, that we're still over a couple, almost a month away from past signing day, and we're still have that zest. You see every high school coach, a little small college coach. The kids who will be here today or tomorrow are the kids that want to play, and that's how recruiting has changed. But thank goodness for the coaches, and thank goodness for yourself, for that you guys helped me out a great, when I first started in this state, There was really nobody. Bill Buckhalter had come a little bit later. He came 3 years later. The only one that I ever remember that even did recruiting nationally was a guy out of West Virginia, Wheeling, West Virginia, and that was it. And then Max Emfinger came, and then Tom Lemon came. I never heard of those guys before. So, but you know what? Thank goodness for everybody that what they're doing is getting the word out, and that's what I do. And what we do, and we have a great chance to do, is get almost 100 new names statewide out every week. We have 2,500 names for 14, 15, and 16 out. That way we've watched every kid, little vignettes of every kid that they send us, video, either YouTube or Huddle, and we watch them, and whatever source that they give, you know, videos through, and we put them up, and we get them out there, and then we talk, we promote them on our South Florida High School Sports website. We uncover more kids, because every week we give you another 15, and before you know it, it's December, and we've put out 300 new kids.
Yeah.
And where else can you do that?
Well, and we love it, because it's a great reference pool for us. And folks, if you don't know Larry Bluestein, I know you know him. A lot of people from around the nation that watch the NCRA Sports Network. This is Larry Bluestein. He is all about the kids and a legend in South Florida, all over the state of Florida, putting in countless hours. And Larry, I want to thank you for coming
and
talking to us here at the BCA Small College Fair.
Anytime.